So we'll talk about oral communications at this point. Is anyone that wishes to address the board? Seeing none, we'll move on to consideration of late additions to the agenda or additions and deletions to the consent and regular agenda. And we are going to move item 4, approved minutes, to the regular agenda. It will be the first item on the regular agenda. We'll keep the number 4. And that leaves the two items 5 and 6 on the consent agenda. And they are the Finance Committee minutes from last Monday and the Finance Committee recommendation to accept the March 2018 financial reports. Tom, could you talk a little bit about that?
We reviewed the financial reports and our revenues are up a little bit for the satellite services this past month, which is good, going in the right direction. And I think that's really all we need to say about that. We recommend approval.
Okay. I'll make a motion to approve the consent agenda.
I'll go ahead and second that.
Great. We have a motion and a second. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
And opposed or abstentions? Seeing none, let's move to item 4 in the minutes. And Tom, you wanted an addition.
Yeah, I want to actually amend the minutes for item 9, which was consider approval of security system expense reimbursement. Just to clarify, since this involves reimbursement to the landlord, contingent upon the landlord agreeing to some changes for the future. So let me read how that would, how I would like to have it amended. Executive Director Reed reported that there will be security patrols in addition to the cameras. Not sure if the cost will be one-time or ongoing. Director Mannheim wanted to make sure that reimbursement of security costs to the landlord is contingent upon landlords executing changes to the master lease that ensure future capital improvements are only made after consulting with tenant.
That's correct.
Do you have that?
I did.
Write it in written form?
I can hand that to you.
Thank you very much.
That is perfect.
Right. And then continuing on, I guess actually that would be the end of, so from the point where it says make sure that all of the following, the remaining language there, the last of that sentence will be replaced with what I just
Okay, great.
And it should say motion to approve as amended.
Yes, my motion also, that's right, my motion on that item was to approve the item as amended.
Okay.
So do we vote on that?
And I would like to move,
no, we approve the amendment. I'd like to second that, because, you know, I remembered very clearly, and it was so well stated, so thank you, Tom, for reminding us of that.
Okay. So we have a motion and a second on approving the amendment, approving the minutes as amended. And I'll take the vote. All in favor say aye.
Aye. Aye.
Opposed or abstentions? Seeing none, we'll go on to the report of the executive director.
Okay. Well, we're having a very good month. It's we've been very the place has been very busy, the parking lot has been full, and there's all kinds of really nice happenings in the co-working center. So, and as Tom said, we are up this month. We're up about $2,000, so we're pretty good. All our offices are full, and we have one office that we have for people that have buckets of hours, but that's more than an office would rent for, so that's a good thing. And there's a lot of activity in the cafe, so we're really excited about that. There comes the report on closed captioning.
The soccer.
Get ready. So we're providing live captions now of the Board of Supervisors meetings. They're going out live, and they look pretty good. They're raw captions, though. There can be errors, and so we'll be cleaning them up. And we have got that part of the work flow going as well. The guys have a chart that's really fun to look at about where all this stuff goes as it flows through our various channels and the ways that whether it's live or a stream or on cable or on our website or on your phone, it's a whole deal. So right now, most of it's happening. We are captioning the live meetings, which is good. We have, we are captioning, we're fixing the captions, and so when they're rebroadcast, they're captioned correctly. When they stream live, our player doesn't allow, as it stands now, our player doesn't allow closed captions. And we've always been sort of mystified by that because, you know, it's the law. So how could anybody use that player if they don't have captions? And we've discovered today that it might be, Victor thinks it's a switch in the elemental that we need to turn on, and once the caption, once the player sees the captions come, it'll, a switch will appear there so we can turn, you can turn on or off closed captioning. So we think it's 2 days away from being finished, and that would be our last hurdle. Once we can get captions on the live stream, we're good. So we're almost there, and it won't be long now, I'm sure. We'll have it all wrapped by next month, by the next meeting. So we are also streaming live now a couple of our channels. We can't stream our public access channel because, well, we stream it on our player, but we want to stream it with captions, and we had moved all our streams were live on YouTube, which is pretty cool. They look great, and the player is easy, and you can search for things. But they won't allow us to play our regular one of our streams, the public access stream, because Democracy Now! Has commercials in it, apparently, or something that YouTube thinks are commercials. So we're having a little trouble with that. So two channels are being streamed live on YouTube, and the other one is just in our player. But we'll work that out. It just happened. So we're over the weekend, they booted us off. So we'll figure out why, and we'll get that fixed. We did 15 government meetings in April, or we will by the time April is over. And we did some work in the co-working center. We, under the equipment and facilities heading, we painted the trim on all of the doors on this side of the building. We changed it from gray to brown. And next Thursday, a muralist will come in. Well, not a muralist, actually, he's a wallpaper hanger, who will come and put this beautiful mural on the wall there that will look like ivy, and it'll go floor to ceiling, and it'll be lovely. So then it's going to look very nice over there. And we're also getting blinds for the windows in the offices because we have some doctors who come, and they need privacy.
Those are the interior windows?
Yeah, some of them. We have a couple psychologists to come and use the offices, and they would rather close the blinds. So we're getting bids on blinds we can use on the inside of those offices. And we are working, I'm still working on the kitchen. I got a design for a peninsula, and it looks very nice. And it's just that they don't have the right, their wood colors don't match the colors that are in the kitchen. So they have maple and we have blonde wood. So we're working now on maybe a painted version. So I'll keep you posted. Let's see. We bought some new equipment this month for professionals. We got from a friend of Maitreya's a very nice camera dolly. So, and it's a nice, easy one. The camera dollies that I'm used to working with have actually metal tracks like trains. We can come all together, and they're really heavy to store. And this just has kind of a round, like rubber tube that it rolls on. And it's very quiet and smooth. And it'll do two things. It'll go on the tracks, or you can just, it has wheels, and you can just roll it around in a studio like ours with a nice flat floor. We can do that. And so it's a more advanced piece of equipment, but that's what we're hoping to offer is, you know, we want to be the resource for producers who want to do really high quality work but can't afford that equipment. So we bought that, and we're also working with a local company that does a lot of photography, but and so they would like to have the right lighting for it, and they can't afford to invest in the whole package, but they would be able to pay rental fees. So we bought it, and they'll be renting it, and it should arrive here hopefully before May 1st, which is when they'd like to rent it. So, and they'll rent it throughout the year, that'll be good for us, and then it'll be available. There's lots of DSLR users, and these are strobe light especially for them. And so we have three of them and some fun things that go with them to help shape the light, as they like to say in the biz. And with some boxes and stuff like that, remote control and things. So it should, it's a very nice kit, and it's, and it's what everybody wants to use. So we should get a lot of good rentals out of that. Last week I talked to you about, last month I talked to you about a local ad agency that I was working with. It's a Google partner, to see about a marketing plan for us. So they did create a really nice marketing plan. They're hardly charging us anything to do it, because they just, they like to work with nonprofits, but usually what they have doesn't work with the Google plan for nonprofits. But because we actually have things like equipment rentals, it works. So they're real excited to try it. So I'm working with them on that now. I signed the contract, and I have to give them some language and for our websites that we want to build a more robust about page on our website that shows what we do as a nonprofit in a bigger way. We have a nice mission statement, but it doesn't really show that we have, you know, we're giving high school kids equipment, or that people can come here and learn, and we need pictures and a good story. So we're working on that. And we have a new marketing intern whose focus is to promote the studio, and she's been in a couple of times so far, only two times she's been here, but she's done a great job, so I expect good things for her. And that's kind of it. It's kind of a short report, but we're in profit for April, which is really good, and significantly so. It's not like a few hundred dollars like usual. We're really, this time it's meaningful.
Yes, excellent.
Great.
Okay, any other questions for Becca?
Just curious about the lights. So they're just for photography. They're not video lights.
They're strobe lights.
They just flash,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, so, yeah. Okay. They're only for photography. Very cool.
Still
very
good.
I guess if you wanted a strobe effect.
I guess if you wanted a skeleton kind of thing. like in the cartoons.
Very cool. Hopefully they'll get a lot of use.
Oh yeah, I think so. I think so, because they told me that they'll tell everybody that they know that works with those lights. So we should, it's what everybody wants to rent. It's what everyone wants to have, but it's just too expensive.
Right.
Mm-hmm. So we'll be able to help a lot of people in the community that want to do that kind of photography.
That's great.
Excellent.
Okay. So that goes right into number 8. That's the annual budget. So Becca has prepared an annual budget, and it's been through the finance committee for the county, specifically the county and the city, and we will be asking, according to our people at the county, for a 1-year extension of our contract. So we won't be going in June for a new contract. It will be a 1-year extension. And as part of that, Becca has to submit the budget and a work plan. And so you have in your packet the budget, and as what we did is, you see the new numbers is the first numerical column, and then last year's budget is next to it. Mm-hmm. And then Becca had broken it down to how much it comes out a month, and then we put in what we've spent for the first 9 months of this fiscal year divided by 9. Mm-hmm. So I think that gives a couple of really good reality checks for what her budget looks like. You'll notice some things like, we found bank charges going much higher than originally had been budgeted, but that's been taken care of. Becca has budgeted about $250 a month on average, $3,000 for the year. For 9 months to date, it's been about $235 a month, so I think it's a pretty good number. Whereas you can see last year, for this fiscal year, it was budgeted at $1,600, but if you look at the financial report that was just approved, you'll see that we've spent already quite a bit more than that this year. Mm-hmm. I just wanted to pick on that one as one that I'm familiar with, to show you how Becca has adjusted her budget to match the reality of this last year.
Mm-hmm. If I could mention one other thing, which was a suggestion of the Finance Committee. If you look at facilities and equipment, 4120, which is essentially the revenue that we get through our contract with Satellite, you'll see that actually we're projecting less revenue. So this current budget year, we projected $150,000. Next year, we're projecting $126,000.
Mm-hmm.
That's not that we're expecting things to be worse. It's that we asked Becca to project the budget based on what we've been doing versus any projected increases. has a more conservative approach. So there are a couple of changes like that. I know another change is that we've folded in both the costs and the revenue we expect to get for closed captioning, which is a significant new item.
And Keith, I just also wanted to thank Becca and our large staff of two people of keeping the costs, you know, every month.
Yes.
The costs are reasonable. I mean, if they go over, there's a reason. There's nothing in here that's, you know, I think unneeded or, you know, it's just, it's been well managed this year. And I want to second what Tom said. So I remember I was at that discussion, and I feel more comfortable with that figure, and then we'll go up from there, and I'll be happy.
And there's nothing more important to the board than making you happy.
Well, and as you can see, like Tom said, for the revenues projected for next year, they're essentially what we've done over the first 9 months,
mm-hmm.
and we've continued to increase our revenues over 9 months.
Mm-hmm.
If you look at it 8 months, it wouldn't be quite as close to her projection. And if I include this month to date, we would be making more than her projection because we're doing well this month. And it's a variable business. One of the most exciting things for me has been in February, early March, we lost a couple of big offices. I was, I'm sure Becca too, panicking. And very quickly those offices were turned over. And in the process, the number of people using our cafe went up. And instead of us looking at, oh no, we've got some vacancies, we're looking at a fully subscribed utility doing better than we projected. So we could celebrate this month and panic last month. And that's one of the things about this business is that you just have to have intestinal fortitude.
And a conservative assumption.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
Okay.
Excellent report.
Motion?
I was going to just ask first if there's any other questions about the proposed budget. It's our April thing we do every year. Yes.
What is equipment service under operating revenue?
Question that the Finance Committee asked. Becca, please.
Yeah. We've been investigating is sort of like the thing that I did with the company that needs those lights. We buy them and they're able to rent them. And that comes under actually facilities and equipment. But what we'd like to do is maybe find a place that makes video or that could make content for the channel that would be appropriate and install the whole equipment there for them to use. And it would be there in their place and they would lease it from us. So it would be something like one of the chambers, a city government might do that. Maybe Loudoun Nelson would do that. Just a place that might need equipment more often.
Mm-hmm.
It depends on the price break on how many times would you use it a year. Is it better to rent or to lease? And if it's better to lease, and if that's tax advantageous to them to lease, then that's what's going in there. I haven't put a whole bunch of money in there.
Right.
I don't
no,
know
I just
how
was
many I'll find that can do it, but I think I'll find one or two.
Okay. Yeah, because I think equipment service is on the expense side, not the
it's not servicing equipment.
Yeah, it's basically offering it as a
service.
Okay.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
If you can come up with a better name,
no,
we can call it whatever we want.
It's something that's come out of our development committee meetings.
Yeah.
This idea. So. Okay. Any other discussion on it?
I noticed the SWAS is that software as a service.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. And so I'm just curious, how many Adobe licenses do we maintain? Do we, you know, offhand?
I think we have eight.
Eight of them?
Yeah.
Two in the suites and six for the smaller.
Mm-hmm. Six
laptops.
In the laptops.
And it's the full Creative.
Oh, yeah.
Cloud.
It's a whole ball of wax.
The whole thing.
Nice. Okay.
And we teach classes. You know, if people want to take a class in Photoshop and Premiere and
After Effects.
And maybe at some point we'll do Audition, you know, audio.
Yeah, there's so much in that.
We have all that classes being offered.
Hmm. Well, $360 a month seems pretty reasonable for that.
Oh, yeah. Plus, we sometimes rent those laptops. People use them to edit projects just out in the cafe space.
Oh, really? Okay.
Yeah.
Excellent.
Quite a deal.
Yeah, it is a really good deal.
It is amazing. You know, when I do my program, half-hour program, you know, sometimes have to edit it a little bit.
Hmm.
So then I get a computer, I rent it, and, you know, I pay very little. Oh, gosh, I think it's like $6 for if you're not a member, and I pay $4 for as a member.
An hour.
And then a couple hours, and then I have a nicely edited program.
Not better than having to spend $50 a month to get the whole wall of wax, and you're not only going to use it for a couple hours.
Exactly. So it's very, very handy. You know, when I did the program with the library, I think I edited one of them. And you get a better program.
Mm-hmm.
And so I highly recommend it to all the producers.
Mm-hmm.
That
it's also good for like a local graphic artist who like a certain version of those pieces and don't want to upgrade, but they have a client that uses the upgraded version. They can come here, just change a file, and take off. They don't have to pay that monthly fee.
Mm-hmm.
They can use it when they need it. There's one more piece of equipment I forgot to tell you guys about. We got a new Mac editor for one of the edit suites, and it is the big new Mac 10 core system, so it's very speedy. It's black and sleek and fancy, and it's a great machine to edit on. It's really speedy, and it's connected to the Creative Cloud, so it's done everything, and it's a big thing. If they call it the Mac Pro, I think.
And it looks like a space heater
CPU
or something like that.
Oh no, it's not
looks
round.
Like a waist cam.
Nope, that sounds cool. It's a square black. It's all black though. It's got like this flat mouse and a screen that's like the thing that's a piece of paper, and it's beautiful and speedy. So people can come in and use it, and it's one of those things that's really pricey, but it's a good thing. So if you want to experiment with it before you buy one, we've got them.
If you want to try to edit some 4K video at 60 frames per second or something like that, and it can keep up with that, huh?
Mm-hmm.
Huh?
Yeah.
Excellent.
Okay.
You looking for a motion?
Unless there's any other questions about the budget.
I'll make a motion to approve the budget for 2018-2019.
I will second that motion.
Okay. We have a motion and a second. All those in favor say aye.
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 Opposed or abstentions? Seeing none, we're going to go on to the oral report from the Volunteer Advisory Committee. That's the photo.
Thank you. I don't have much this month. I mean, I'm very pleased that some of the producers that were doing specifically music shows, that they have come back. I mean, it's very hard for them, and sometimes they have people come from the Bay Area, and they want to play and be recorded. It's really, I mean, it's those programs are probably one of the hardest programs to do, and they do them. I'm really thrilled. And just wanted to let you know that, again, we will be doing our community service by inviting in a journalism class from Cabrillo College. They'll be doing two programs this year. Based on the quality that we want to get, they'll only do one time, which means two groups will do a half-hour program. And they'll be on Monday, May 14th. And so they already have their topics selected, and they have to do background, and you know, and somebody does the hosting. So it's quite an experience for them. And so I hope in the future that we'll get some of the people that we gave computers to, like people from Aptos High or Watsonville High, that they come in and, you know, be in Cabrillo and then do the programs here. So we need to build on all the things that we're doing. So that's exciting to me, and that's really all I want to say. I leave it up to you to talk about the spotlight.
Okay.
A nice one. That's it for me.
All right. Now we'll move to the oral report of the board chair. I just wanted to mention, as Matilda did, that we did a nonprofit spotlight on the new Capitola Library, and we had quite a cast here who did an outstanding job of being extremely positive, made a great show that I'm getting lots of positive feedback on. I really appreciated those who came and were on the program, and what a great job they did. And I just spoke with the chair of the umbrella organization, the Friends of the whole Santa Cruz Public Library, and they want to do a very similar thing for the whole system, because while Capitola Branch is just finishing the private fundraising phase and moving into the public phase, so it's a good time for them to publicize that the public phase is starting. The system is just starting the private phase. So that's probably gonna be the next program.
Great.
Get the similar crew for the whole system. So we're very positive about libraries.
I know, we've had two programs a night, and those were so wonderful. You know, you have some people working at the library.
We do.
Yes, absolutely.
We have some of the most wonderful people, absolutely.
And so community-minded.
Yes.
And ready with the story and lots of experience, they stay around, which is really wonderful, so.
You remind me, I was at the Capitola Library on Saturday taking testimonials from anyone who was willing to stand in front of the camera and just say 5 or 10 seconds why they love the library. And you already know this, Janice, but without exception, they all kept saying how wonderful the staff is and how much they appreciate it, how much they help them and can count on them.
We like to hear that.
Yeah, so. And the other thing I was surprised about is the constant traffic of people in and out.
Oh, yes.
That branch is gonna really
be
messed.
It's one of our busiest branches, and they've been in a temporary facility for 17 years, so that may be the definition's temporary.
in schools, that's just halfway there.
So that's the only thing I had to report on. Are there any staff requests for items to appear on the next meeting agenda or board member requests?
I guess we'll talk some more a little bit about the orientation, the retreat that we wanted to do in August.
Right, we're going to try and plan. That was the request last time.
Yeah.
Try and shoot for August.
Yeah.
Maybe Becca, is June going to be when you take your extension of the contract to the Board of Supervisors?
May, I think.
May? So then maybe just follow up with us on what happens there.
Right.
Yeah, I don't think it needs to be an item, but just in your report.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah.
So as we mentioned, we're going to go for a contract extension, so no changes to the contract that we know of.
Okay.
And you approve the budget.
So it's just an extension.
Okay. So any announcements about anything? I think we've been announcing a lot of stuff already. I'd like to thank the volunteers that helped produced tonight's board meeting on TV. Jim Russo, Richard DeSell, Linda Janakis, Terrence Scott, Gene Kratzer, and Sherry Ross, thank you for producing tonight's program. And with that, I'll take a motion for adjournment.
I move to adjourn the meeting.
Second.
Okay. So.
We just have to say yes.
You want to say approved?
Aye.
Okay, so the meeting is adjourned.
5:57.
5:57.